Now let's talk about widgets in layers, because we have seen widgets before when creating a page. So these things that you can add to the flow part in a page are also widgets. But widgets are not just useful in flow part, but widgets can also be put into something called layers. Now the idea here is that when you are creating a page like this and you throw together the content of a flow part with widgets, then those widgets will be only displayed on this specific page, on that specific URL that the page has. Now, what if you want to put some boxes, like an info box or a little contact box on every page on your website, or on a lot of pages, like on every blog post, a contribution page, donate me here, or links to your YouTube channel or something like that. Now you can still use widgets for that, but not with flow parts, but with layers. So let's see how that works. If you go to design and widgets, you will see the UI for that. And well, there are a couple of new concepts, so let's check them out. Well, first of all, we have zones, and there are also layers. What are zones? Zones are areas that the theme can define, and once the theme defined, you can configure under zones here, available zones, content and footer, as well as content and footer here. That's the reason for it. The zones are areas that the theme can display on the front end. The current theme actually has more zones than this, the block theme, but only these zones are currently configured under settings there. We could change that, and if we use the same names for the zones here that the theme displays, then it would continue to work. During the theme development part, the theme development tutorials will actually see how to display such zones. For now, let's just remember that the zones are areas on the front end that the theme can display. And well, currently we have two zones, content and footer, which of course correspond to the rough content area on the website. So this area, well, maybe just this one. And we also have a footer, well, which is this one. And we can put widgets, so exactly the same widgets that we can put into flow part we can put into flow part under the page as well. These are exactly the same widgets. It's just that we are not putting them under a given page in flow part, but rather we are putting them into various zones. But we are actually not just putting them into zones, but we are also putting them into layers. Layers here are pretty much containers for widgets. The layers determine when a given widget is displayed, because I might put a contact widget here in the content zone, but I might not actually want to display it on every single page, so we have to restrict it somehow. Let's actually see that. So let me add a widget, and again, this can be a raw HTML widget, which will be named a demo widget. And again, we'll have just some raw HTML here. And yeah, two things to note here. First of all, although widgets use again the same title part as blog post and page, but here you can also configure whether to actually render it. Because, you know, for widgets, that's not always necessary. And although you can hide the title for pages and blog posts too, there is a lot of things you can do with them. It's also convenient to have this checkbox just for widgets. And actually, we won't want to render the title for this particular widget. And secondly, you can also specify the corresponding layer for the widget. Let's leave it on always for now, and let's see what happens. So I've published the widget. Here it is. Now let's go back to the homepage, and we see that now our widget's content is here. And if we go to this blog post, then again the widget is there. And that's because it is on the always layer, as we have seen. And let's check out the always layer. The always layer, well, the name is a telltale sign, but the always layer is, well, a container of widgets that are displayed on every page. And why this is the case is not because of the name, but because of the widget rule. The widget rule is a logic expression that determines whether the layer is active under the current URL. And, well, of course, this is a very, very simple logic expression, just true. But under the documentation, you can also check out how this works. So if you search for layers, you will see the reference of the layers module. And here you can also check out which rules can be used and mix and matched, because you can also AND or together these rules. And as you can see, there is, for example, something, there is a function to determine whether the layer should be displayed based on the URL, or whether the user is authenticated or not authenticated. And something like that happens on this other layer, the homepage layer, because the homepage layer uses the isHomePage function. And well, you might have already guessed it, but the homepage layer is only active on the homepage. So if we go back to our widget and switch over to homepage and refresh our blog post, now the widget is gone here. And if we go back to the homepage, it is there, because of course the layer is only active actually on the homepage. So you can also create your own layers here. You can also edit or delete built-in layers. Layers are also something that you can export into recipes. This is actually how these layers were created, because the blog recipe contains these layers. So widgets and layers are another avenue for content management. Widgets are a concept that we have already seen, so it's just reusing the same concept here. And of course, you can also create your own widgets, because widgets are just content items of given content types. But we'll also do that from code a bit later.